What's up, guys? It's I7RCT bringing you not another live stream, but actually a video review. And what we're going to be reviewing today, if you excuse me here for a second, we're going to be reviewing this little sucker. Where is it? Over here. Namco Museum for the Switch. Now, this is a title that kind of fell on the wayside with our recent releases, because with all of the hype that was going on with Splatoon 2 and Splatfest, basically I haven't had much time to cover everything that's been coming out. I try my best, but sometimes it's kind of hard. Having the recent vacation time, which was just 1 week, I just wanted to get away from, you know, the whole doing the stream stuff, so I decided that to include this week as well, and just, you know, focus on enjoying the day off and playing some games, especially Splatoon that has me hooked. But I also wanted to do something, you know, for you guys, in case you wanted to see some content, at least check out Namco Museum, which just came out for the Nintendo Switch. And we're going to be moving here to the side. Yeah, why am I covering this one? Well, basically, to me, this game, Namco Museum, is what I believe, in my case specifically, it's my opinion, that this is kind of like a token game. And what I mean by token game is, just like Street Fighter 2, you know, this is, in this case, is a collection of old games, all arcade classics. Being in the retro scene and emulation scene, you guys know for a fact that I do not necessarily need this game in order to play these classics, because as an emulation fan and enthusiast, of course I have all of these versions that I can play full screen, HD resolutions, etc., etc. However, it is a token game, because as somebody who wants to support the industry and the Switch as a new platform, we need to show Namco that we have the power with, you know, money-wise, with the dollar, with purchases. And as a good faith, I decided to purchase this, not out of need, but more kind of like nostalgia mixed with goodwill and faith that if we purchase this game, more Namco titles will come later on. Remember that the Switch, even though it's selling very well, is in a very precarious situation in terms of development and third-party development, because they want to see that the system succeeds and there's enough install base and enough people buying their products for them to come out with, you know, more titles. So in the case of Capcom, it worked. Street Fighter 2 Ultimate basically sold over 400,000 units, so it already has Capcom saying, pledging support to the system, more titles coming up. And even though Namco has been there from day one, it won't hurt. It won't hurt, you know, getting the game, you know, and having these nice titles with you. It's a digital purchase, of course, but it doesn't really take up much of your SD card anyway. So, yeah, be on the lookout. It has around, let me change here, it has around 10, 11 titles, which are all classics, of course. Let me bring the music down here, so you can enjoy the game sounds. And of course, you have in this, which I believe this is going to be the first of several Namco museums, because that's the way that they operate, or they have done in the past with past consoles. They bring out an original Namco museum, they put in some titles in there. Then in a second or third or fourth iteration, they bring out even more titles, sometimes more recent titles. Now this one has, at least on the Switch side of things, it has something particular, which is that you are able to rotate the screen. And something that I've been asking for basically since the Switch launch, which is being able to play shoot 'em ups in a vertical, you know, angle, which is kind of cool. Now, I haven't messed too much with it, but I did notice that even though you can rotate the screen to play it in portable, you're not the controls do not change with the rotation. So there's something I need to work something out. I'll keep in touch with you guys and let you guys I'll let you guys know how that worked out. But for the time being, if you want to play vertical mode like this, you're going to have to either play with a Pro Controller, but putting the portable Switch sideways and actually playing is going to be a pain in the ass. That being said, let's move back to our standard angle here, horizontal. And it has, of course, a ton of options, controller options, configuring buttons and stuff like that, how to play the game, which is a little small tutorial. But of course, anybody who has been playing these titles for a while know that, you know, how this works out. So I'm going to run down here quickly through the amount of titles here, and I'm going to go actually... Yeah, Pac-Man for the first title. I have Galaga, one of my favorites here, the granddaddy of shoot-em-ups. You got Dig Dug, another favorite in the arcades. Tower of Draga, very popular with RPG fans. Sky Kid, which I'm not too familiar with, but I'm guessing if it's Namco, it has to have something very appealing to the gameplay. Rolling Thunder, I am familiar with this one. Galaga 88, which of course we covered when Redic Outlaws went over there to Fun Spot, remember? Part of the arcade shoot 'em ups. We have Splatterhouse, of course, a title that was only once, you were only once able to play it on Turbo Graphics, and then eventually came to Genesis. Tank Force. Sequel to Rolling Thunder, Rolling Thunder 2, Pac-Man Versus, which is basically a title that was made specifically to play with basically the GameCube controller, and you would hook up a Game Boy Advance system to the GameCube, and you can play basically a Versus. And each player, you know, would be a ghost and try to catch Pac-Man, etc., etc. Fun thing to have. But we're going to keep going through the titles. And we go back to Pac-Man. Now, the cool thing about this, as I'm going to use Galaga as an example, you have a normal and challenge mode. I haven't tested challenge mode. As you can see here, let me move this to the gameplay to full screen. As you can see here, it comes with a very nice overlay, kind of very similar to the setup that I have in my Hyperspin. And guys, you guys who know me from years back know that I still have my Hyperspin setup and my emulation stuff. And this is one of the appealing stuff of Hyperspin, is that you can have these nice overlays that emulate the arcade. But the thing with this is that it's not completely locked into place. You can actually move the display or mess around with the display to actually use more space in case you find it a little too confined or too small to play in. All you have to do is mess around with the zoom. And it's going to reach a point, you see, that it's going to move outside. Outside of the overlay, you can change the different aspect ratio. You do it here manually, but scan lines, you can have your scan lines also to kind of give that feeling. And you can change also the overlays, something more of your liking. Rather keep it in the first one, it's pretty nice. And from there we can actually play the game. So let's give this one a try. Yeah, that's hardcore. Now, the Pro Controller works just fine with this game, and I figure it's going to be working just fine with the rest of the titles. And the sound, which is something that you need for immersion, is really on point and spot on. See if I can manage to get to the bonus round so I can show you the other titles, because if not, I'm going to stay hooked playing this one. There we go. Ah, crap. Nice hit. Pretty rusty with the bonus round. And I got an extra life. Now from here, I have two choices. One, I can just save the game. It'll save the progress, and next time I boot up Galaga, it's gonna start from there, or give me the option to start from there. From here, I can actually go back to the main menu and choose another game. Now, all of this is very straightforward. You have all the same options that I showed you there. You have them with at least all the games that I've tried so far. I haven't tried them all. And this is the arcade original Splatterhouse. As you can see, this one, I kind of already widened the screen to make it a bit more to my liking, that way I can use more real estate from the HD monitor, of course. Now, of course, this game is also more to my liking because there's a lot of blood and gore, or goo and gore, I guess. Give me my, hatchet, or my cleaver. Cleaver, beaver cleaver. Oop. Go away, vomit. These freaking bats. My cleaver. I don't want that freaking bat thing. So yeah, that's the end of our Friday the 13th Jason clone. Very badass indeed. Now from here I can also reset in case I don't want to continue from there, and we'll start it over. So yeah, we come now to the point where we have to think and reassess and reevaluate if this is really worth the $29.99, which is the asking price for it. I consider, again, if you look at it from the point of view of an old-time gamer or hardcore gamer from the past who enjoys the arcade originals, having this, especially on a digital title, I wouldn't bother with a physical copy of this because of the small size of the file size anyway. But for those who love collecting, that could be an option. I don't know if there's a physical version. However, I think that for $29.99, I think it's a pretty good token purchase, you know, for establishing a goodwill with future Namco releases on the system. It's something nice to have, and who knows, maybe they'll come out later on with more iterations, with more incredible games from their, of course, their classic library. Hopefully, if this sells well, there's also the possibility of having companies like Konami and Capcom do their own collections, or Data East, and you know, those company arcade companies from the past that had great titles. So you never know, guys. But I consider this a very good purchase. So consider it, guys, if you are a fan of classic gaming, arcade style kind of games, and you enjoy Namco titles, go for it. This is a, I would say, two thumbs up if I had a rating system, which I don't. I would say in a scale of 1 to 10, it would be a good solid 8. You'll get your money's worth and you have some fun with it, and it runs pretty well. So that's going to be all for now, guys. Hope you enjoyed this review, quick review, and hopefully next week I'll be around with the stream. So take care, guys, and I'll see you guys later. Ciao, peace.